Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Let's Play for Indiana Jones and the Emperor's Tomb. So we are now in Hong Kong, and I'm just gonna let the intro cinematic play. Enjoy these nice PS2 block characters. Trying to get all artsy with the cinematic sweeping shots, I like it. That glass doesn't look terrible, but...
Have I mentioned how absolutely stunning you look in that dress?
It's the third time...
And he's still coming on strong.
Let's stick to business, shall we?
So, where's your smuggler?
Fuck! I don't want to.
He's helped me several times. He'll be here.
And he'll take us to Kai's fortress?
Yes, where we'll find the mirror pieces and the Pa Cheng.
The Pa what?
You'll need more than your gun once you're in Pa Cheng's tomb. There are things worse than Nazis.
Wonderful.
Something's not right. Wait here.
I love how she's like, yeah, my contact will be here. And then literally 5 seconds later, she's like, something's not right. Like he never saw that shit from across the bar. He's just right there. Just right in his eye line. At least she puts up a- Oh my god, that shot's terrible! Oh my god, it was just literally a bunch of just JPEGs. It was just a bunch of frozen models. I never even noticed that before. That's incredible. That's an incredible shot. So, here we go. Chapter 4, I believe this is. And it is like 95% just a combat chapter. And these guys absolutely suck to fight. I would definitely advise grabbing like weapons if you can. Ouch! Look at that bullshit. Okay, at least he killed his friend. I would definitely advise grabbing weapons if you can find them, because these guys are a complete pain in the ass without them. Ow. There we go. And they just keep coming, like they are all over the damn place. He's... Oh, Jesus. Where are you? Ow. My face. I don't know how he blocked that, but sure. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Give me a table leg. Fuck. Ow. Oh, come on! How did- like, what? Ouch. This is not going well. There we go. Jesus Christ. So yeah, those guys are an absolute nightmare. And yeah, if you can grab the chairs, grab anything you can to fight them with, because fists and just feet, like, they don't tend to get the job done. You'll probably take quite a bit of damage. You can't pull this lever. It's already been pulled, so we have to find something to reset it with. There's also some bottles over here to throw at them, but I find that it's pretty tricky to actually hit them with the bottles, just because they zip around and move so much. You're kind of trapped in here as well. Like, there's nowhere really to go to get away from them. Thankfully, it's a pretty huge area, but you can't really run away very well. So the only way we can go is into here, where there's going to be a couple more guys running up the stairs, I believe. No? Well, they'll be down here. Oh, there we go. Ah, pick the bad one. Ow, god. Ow! Jesus, I might die here. Oh. How are you both still alive? Oh my god, go away. Ah! There's probably more guys down here, I bet. Is there anything I can use? A fountain, a med kit, anything? Jesus Christ. No, leave me alone. Okay, one guy's dead. Go away. Is he dead? Oh, Jesus. I need health so bad, I can't believe I actually survived that shit. Okay. Please, God, give me health or, like, a med kit or something. I don't think any of these boxes are breakable either. And oh, what?! Are you kidding me?! That would be horror. I would die, isn't it? Fuck. Okay, I'll just probably skip ahead to back where we were. Son of a bitch. And we're back, everybody. Sorry about that. That was the lamest way to die I think you could have possibly got. After he survived that shit. And then just immediately fucking died. That was really, really fucking terrible. But anyway, once you clear out those two guys, there's a ladder up here that leads to the next section that we want to go. And I believe there are medkits up here. Here. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, you had your canteen on you the whole time, too. Wonderful. That would have been nice to know. Okay, so you do have your canteen on you if you want to fill up some life. So that's good. Climb up here and you can see Mei Ying at least putting up a little bit of a fight. Time to kick some ass as she flies across the room. Yeah, this one really ramps up the combat difficulty a lot. But thankfully, it is a pretty short level, so that's pretty good. Some of these guys also have swords, so that's definitely a major issue. Some of them also carry these throwing knives, but they aren't, again, the best, because it's really hard to hit these guys with moving objects. There's also something called an iron skin potion, which is going to make your skin a little bit tougher. And I should have drank that beforehand, I guess. Oh, Jesus. Really bad place to be. Okay, there we go. Okay. I think you can carry up to three knives on your person. Three throwing knives, so that's good. Here is the switch to reset the switch down there. So we've completed kind of the main objective, at least that we know of right now. Can't go this way, I don't think. So we continue on. This level is pretty linear. There's usually only one way to go. So it's pretty tough to get lost. This part is not the best. So here you're going to face another gauntlet of dudes. Another sword. Also in this little room here is where you find the first artifact of the level. The Taisu mask. And thankfully they are pretty easy to find in this chapter, except for the last one's a little bit difficult. Let's see if I can hit somebody with a throwing knife. There we go. And no, of course not. Oh, right, if they have swords, they just block them anyway. Most useless weapon on earth. Ow. Jesus, what the hell's that? Why can't I do that move? Okay, just keep making your way down the hallway. There's like table legs and chairs in all of these rooms. for you to grab more weapons if you need them. You do need them against these guys. It's also a very good idea to learn how to block as well. If you don't know how to block, it can be a little bit of a problem. Oh, Jesus. I didn't mean... Okay, kill this friend for us. Oh, Jesus, this guy's got knives on him. Not good. You just really gotta block, wait for an opening, and then take your shot at it, because these guys, like, fly all over the damn place. Okay. So only way to go is down this way. Is there anything back here? I don't believe so. Nope. So this is gonna take us to a lovely fountain. Which is much needed after that onslaught. I believe there's a... Okay. Is there a dude out here? No? Okay. Oh, there we go. Who said that? Where are you? I have no idea who said that. Whatever. I'm sure he'll find us eventually. So now we're back in the main area, and you just have to pull this switch to open up the curtain so we can finally get back there to go after Mei Ying. Oh, great. And this guy has a gun, because the game hates us. Ow. Roll, you idiot, roll! Ow. Give me that shit. Back, you beast. There we go. And he's got some nice revolver ammo. And there's also some good stuff over here as well. Some Mauser ammo, sorry. Some more bottles over here, but again, they're kind of useless.
It's full.
Another med kit over here for you, and some more Mauser ammo. If I reload it, can I grab it?
It's full.
No. Okay. So now we got lots of ammunition, so that's good stuff. And just keep following the way that it wants you to go. Like I said before, very linear level. So this door doesn't open, if you want to check it. So thankfully there are some ropes here across the little room to get us to this door here. And this is the end of the level. Don't go up there. You can actually go up here, like walk up, but all that is the door that we originally were on when we came up that ladder, that first set of ladders in the level. So don't bother going down there. There's nothing there. You're just gonna have to go all the way around again. So this is part two of Escape from Hong Kong, and all of these dudes have guns. Ow. So I would advise just not even... What the fuck, Indy? Shoot him. That's embarrassing. Missed from point blank range twice. And this guy is still alive. These fuckers are a pain in the ass. God, I can't believe he missed point blank twice. I better heal up. Before he fucking dies again. There we go. That's more like it. Just a good old-fashioned Indiana Jones shootout. Wish you could see a little bit better here. Oh god. So they've got Mei Ying, they've tied her up. Nice. Oh. Oh shit, there's two of them. Uh-oh. Damn it. No, don't get up on the box, you moron. Jesus Christ. Okay, where's the shotgun? Ow. Wrong guy. Oh, Jesus, I'm not doing well on this ship. And he misses. How does he survive that? Are you kidding me? These guys are just iron body parts, apparently. Oh, fuck me. These guys are ruthless. This is brutal. Like, what the fuck? He can't even get a shot off. Where are you? Okay. Is that all of them? I hope. Looks like it. Okay. Perfect. Finally got them all. So before you go out this way, that's the exit door. Before you do that... Sure, reload it. Not that we can use it anymore anyway. You're going to want to come through this dressing room door. And you're going to find a medkit in here and the second artifact of the chapter, the Longshan Idol. So don't forget to grab that in here. I think the other one opens up as well, but there's nothing in it. Oh, okay. Never mind. There's one door that like opens up and there's nothing in it. Maybe it was last chapter and I just skipped it. But anyway, yeah, that's the escape from... the Golden Lotus, very reminiscent of Temple of Doom. So when you're done, run out here to escape the restaurant. And now we're going to have a little bit of a car chase, again, like Temple of Doom. This is obviously a homage to the intro of Temple of Doom here. Very similar.
Dr. Jones, I presume.
And we meet our character.
I'm here to meet Mei Ying.
Well, you just missed her.
And so I noticed.
Fuck.
Please get in. We must hurry.
Don't you own a car?
Oh, Jesus. Was that a bomb? Or was it just a bird? Something was coming at it. I love how this guy's able to outrun motorcycles and vehicles on the road. Like, just the fastest sprinter on Earth. While carrying a full-grown man. While carrying a full-grown man and a big cart on the back. So this is, like, a very easy, very simplistic level. Just shoot the fuck out of everybody that you see. You can't run out of ammo, so just hold down that trigger and just go for it. So yeah, this guy driving is actually the character from Temple of Doom, that waiter at the beginning of the movie who was killed in the restaurant in that movie. I mentioned, I think, before that this is a prequel to Temple of Doom, and that is that character in the movie. So he makes an appearance in this game. And this level also has the third and final artifact for this chapter as well. It's going to come up on the left side of the... there, right there. Did I get it? I'm not sure if I got it or not. It's in that box, that plate you saw. You need to shoot the box and shoot the little plate. And that is the third artifact of this chapter. It's a little obscure, but that's where it is. You just gotta keep your eyes open for that box on the left side of the screen and shoot it as soon as it comes into play. This street chase also has two parts as well, so that's the end of the first part. And then we go into part two. So if you die from here on out, you will start here instead of all the way back at the beginning. And this is actually the last level of the chapter. It's a very short and sweet chapter. It's like 20 to 30 minutes, depending on how many times you die. It is a pretty, like, difficult chapter combat-wise, though. It's pretty tricky. Just because the enemies have such erratic patterns when fighting, and most of them carry weapons, like Istanbul. So you can definitely get killed a couple times here. This is one of the few parts in the game, I feel, where you're more likely to get killed by combat than platforming. Because there isn't any platforming in this chapter at all. It is like 95% combat. There's no like secret areas to find or tricky jumps to make. There's a little bit like those ropes to swing on in like level 1, and that's pretty much it. The rest is just fighting, moving on to the next area, fighting, etc. So it's a nice break from like the super exploration-heavy chapters previously of Prague and Istanbul. I heard you want him to slow down so these guys can ram you. Again, I just love that this guy is able to outrun cars and motorcycles. Man's calves must be the fucking size of tree trunks. Fucking nuts. And just keep shooting these guys. Keep your finger, like I said, on the trigger. You're not gonna run out of ammo.
We'll head down that alley and cut them off at the docks.
And I think that's the end of the level there. Oh god, his leg is through the cart. That's no good. Yeah, and that's the end of the chapter. And then you just get to watch this ending cutscene here. What was his plan? I guess just to beat the shit out of Von Beck one more time?
To Kai's fortress. A Peng Lai Island, most likely.
We'll have to move fast. Where's your boat?
At the next dock. Hop in.
I think I'll walk.
Why? He did such... Like, the man's superhuman. But anyway, that's actually the end of the chapter. And our next chapter is going to be Peng Lai Lagoon. So I hope you enjoyed that short playthrough, and we'll see you in the next chapter. Peng Lai, thanks. Take care.